सब्सक्राइब करें, प्रेस करें बेल आइकॉन और पाएं मुंबई, नवी मुंबई एवं बॉलीवुड की ताजातरीन खबरें।
Eminent and renowned nuclear scientist Dr. Suresh Haware unveiled the launch of his latest book on nano housing in Mumbai, reiterating his commitment to the ambitious Housing for All initiative. He authored the book, which focuses to resolve the challenges faced by the Indian masses in the housing sector. Union Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari, along with other notable personalities, graced the occasion by their presence. With affordable housing for the masses being a major issue for governments and lawmakers, Prime Minister Narendra Modi's leading visions, Nano Housing, aims to offer solution by offering affordable housing for all. The book launched reveals that more than 40% of families in India's financial capital, Mumbai, reside in deteriorated and shanty localities. Nano Housing, known to be a path-breaking concept, is an outcome of a substantial detailed research which contains the potential to bring to reality the common man's dream of an affordable house at an affordable cost. The book, being an asset, provides benefits to homemakers, academicians, policymakers, students, architects and financiers, offering them a comprehensive analysis of India's housing demands as well as suggestions to reboost the growth in this sector. Speaking at the event, Union Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari stated that a huge chunk of India's population can't afford to acquire houses, and in the years to come, this sector will boom only if propelled by affordability along with inclusion of innovative technologies to bring down the cost of homes without compromising on their quality.
सगळ्यात महत्त्वाचा प्रश्न असा आहे की आज घर घेण्याची क्षमता असणाऱ्या लोकांची पेईंग कॅपॅसिटी काय आहे, हा सगळ्यात महत्त्वाचा प्रश्न. एक काळ असा होता की एक क्लास होता 100% साधारणतः तो 2-3% असेल की 2% असेल किंवा 1% असेल, तो मला माहीत नाही त्याचा नक्की आकडा. तो मुंबईमध्ये होता आणि त्यामुळे 3 कोटी, 4 कोटी, 5 कोटी, 10 कोटी, 15 कोटी, 35 कोटीपर्यंत देखील घरं विकल्या गेली. पण ती पेईंग कॅपॅसिटी असणारा क्लास किती आहे आणि त्याच्यामध्ये घेणारी लोक किती आहेत, याचं सूत्र जे आहे त्याचा अभ्यास न झाल्यामुळे अडचणी आहे. माझ्या हिशोबाने हा क्लास संपला, कमी झाला, त्यामुळे सॅच्युरेशन आलाय. त्यामुळे आता सगळ्यात महत्त्वाचा प्रश्न आहे की आपल्याकडे 4 लेवल आहेत. एक आहे ग्रामपंचायत, त्या ठिकाणी घर घेण्याची ताकद जी आहे, जी ग्रामपंचायत 10,000 खाली लोकवस्ती आहे, तिथली पेईंग कॅपॅसिटी 3 लाखाच्या वरती घर नाही होऊ शकत.
Dr. Suresh Haware revealed that his innovation on nano housing has received appreciation, and pouring his thoughts into his newly launched book, he aims to share his thoughts and recommendations with the masses. He further said that nano housing is an inventive tool which will help to survive and tackle global economic recession and serve the housing needs of the nation.
I have covered in my book the study on the recessions. There are various types of recession. Some are V-shaped, some are W-shaped, some are in the shape of U, L. So many recessions are there. The research covers the study of recession and how to come out of the recession. Now, any business, if you consider, it passes through 4 phases. Initially, it will be introduction phase, then the growth phase, third phase of stabilization, and fourth phase invariably comes in the businesses is the phase of decline. And if this decline is very sharp, then it is called a recession. Now, what is the solution if there is a recession or if there is a decline in the business? And the research says innovation is the only solution. innovation with technology, with material, with processes, with practices, and so many things, but innovation is the only solution. There are a number of strategies available for innovation, and blue ocean strategy is one of the strategy which I have adopted in my research, and the nano housing, my research is the outcome of this blue ocean strategy. Sir, this book, I am very fond of reading this book. I have, whenever I get time, I read this book. I, at least 10 times I must have read this book after it is printed. And let me tell you the speciality of this book is each and every statement I have made in this book is substantiated with the proof, with the evidence. For example, I have made a statement that most of the disputes in the society are related with property or real estate. Now the publisher was not happy with this statement. He wanted the substantiation, proof. What is the proof? I started researching, and I came across a literature, a research paper, wherein a person had made a study of 10 years of court cases in India. Lakhs of cases, and he categorized the cases, say family disputes, matrimonial disputes, property disputes, and came out with ultimate findings that 75% of the disputes are related with property and real estate. So then only the publisher accepted the statement, and my guide accepted the statement, yes, now we can allow you to write this statement. Like that, there are number of statements I made in the book, and everyone has been substantiated. Let me give you three universal findings or global findings about the study. One is much talked about, the unauthorized construction. Now let me tell you that this is a universal phenomenon existing in all the leading countries of the world, mostly third world countries. And sir, around 30-40% of the construction in the world in third world countries is unauthorized construction. There are various reasons, number of parameters which play around for creation of unauthorized housing, but it is the fact of the day. You cannot ignore it. And what is the solution? In first place, it should not happen. That is okay. Secondly, there has to be a penalty, there has to be demolition and so many things. But no country has a machinery who can demolish the existing unauthorized construction. Nobody has. And what about the national wealth that has been invested in this construction? So everyone has to think about and come out with a solution that regularization is the only way. I don't make it a blanket statement. There are variations, there are checks and balances, but regularization is the universally followed practice. Even Maharashtra state government some years back regularized more than 1 lakh buildings in Ullasnagar. Recently, government of India has regularized around 1731 unauthorized colonies in New Delhi. The bill was passed on 28th of November 2019. So it is a universal phenomenon, and we have to live with it as long as we become a developed country. Second study is about the rental housing. Now rental housing exists all over the world. There are houses available on rent. There are companies which are providing houses on rent for students, for bachelors, for service going people. But the picture in India, let me tell you some figures. I have taken these figures from the 2011 census data. In India, the total number of vacant and locked houses are 1 crore and 10 lakhs, and the national housing deficit is 1 crore and 90 lakhs houses. So almost half of the houses of the total housing demand deficit is locked in the country. What about the picture in Maharashtra? The Maharashtra, we have vacant and locked houses in Maharashtra is 20 lakhs. And the housing deficit is 19.4 lakhs. The thing is, if we unlock these houses, we solve the problem of deficit of housing and we reach to faster to the dream of providing housing for all. Rent Control Act is one of the major culprit. There are number of other reasons for keeping these houses locked, but I find and research finds that Rent Control Act needs improvement, and if Rent Control Act all over the nation, if it is improved, then these locked houses can become available for habitation. Third finding is about the homelessness. Sir, there are around 10 crore homeless people all over the world. And in India, there are around 17.7 lakh people who are homeless, who do not have shelter over their head. In Mumbai alone, 57,000 people are homeless. It is not the phenomenon of only undeveloped countries or developing countries. Even United States has 5.54 lakh homeless people. Washington City has, New York City has, and New York City has the maximum number of homeless people in the United States. That is around 74,000 people in New York City are homeless. US government do provide emergency shelter or a night shelter to these people, but they are able to provide that shelter to the tune of 65% of the homeless people only. That means 35% of the people in United States, they sleep on the streets overnight. So these three universal findings, and one more finding is that real estate industry is a local industry, it is not a global industry. There are number of players in India who tried to have their pan-India presence and they have miserably failed. There are number of reasons for that. Number of local parameters you have to consider who are disturbing the industry, and it is not possible for anyone to have that control over the entire country. And that is why I say that this is a local industry. Housing finance is a global industry, but housing construction, housing is a local industry. That has to be kept in mind. And that is why I say think global, but act local. Nano Housing, Amar has already explained, it is a small house, reduced by 25% in size, reduced by rate in 25%. So the total cost comes down to 50%. Though it looks very simple, it is not that simple. Reducing a house by 25% is very, very difficult. Area optimization, so many things go into that. And reducing the rate, again, very difficult. In the rate of a house, number of things goes. Land cost, construction cost, processing cost, material cost, so many things. And innovation and technology, with the use of these, you have to bring down the rates, and then only you can reduce the rate by 25%. In the book, I have dealt with the impact of RERA, GST, demonetization, REIT, Real Estate Investment Trust, which is the future financing source for real estate industry, redevelopment. Sir, Gadkari Sahib is here. He is himself is a businessman. He understands the business from his heart, and he knows the business situation prevailing in India. I don't have to explain it anymore. This real estate industry has digested RERA. It has helped in improving the real estate industry. Demonetization also it has digested. It has come out of the impacts of demonetization. But GST also it has accepted. There is only one lacuna, that input tax credit, if it is provided to the building industry, it will resolve all the problems of industry also, and industry will start flourishing. I have one request that sir, industry needs financial stimulus, and if that comes from the government, industry will survive, because real estate industry has an impact on 269 other industries. It is the largest job provider after agricultural, and therefore this industry has to survive.
Bureau Report, NMTV News.